Andrew, where are you?
Dain, I'm down here.
Why are you so small?
I'm just trying to describe a carbon nanotube. I've got this whole pool noodle and everything.
Nope, see the pool noodle? I'm on the same page. Can you just make yourself big again, please?
Fine.
This time, Andrew and I learn about carbon nanotubes, how they're going to change the world, and we talk to an artist who is inspired by the technology.
I'm trying to do one thing. I try to spruce it up. I try to give the people what they want, which is flash.
I don't think anyone wants that.
Well, I didn't go to film school.
It's unnatural.
Whatever. Pretend that this is a carbon nanotube. A carbon nanotube is a tiny hollow tube made of carbon. Each one can be 3,500 times smaller than the average human hair.
Discovered in 1991 by Sumio Ijima, and since then, they've been researched heavily for their variety of unique uses. Here, why don't we see for ourselves?
That was dramatic.
I'll get you a new one.
Dain, where the hell have you taken us?
We are in the beautiful tropical land of Connecticut.
Connecticut?
Yeah.
I quit the show.
No, Andrew, come on. They're actually doing some cool things here.
Like what?
Mattershift is doing some really awesome stuff with carbon nanotube technology.
All right.
So can you tell us a little bit about Mattershift and what you do here?
Yeah, so we're working on a new way of making things at the molecular level. The idea is to completely recycle and close loop on fuels and materials. We can actually take individual molecules of things we want, like fuels or food or pharmaceuticals, and we can actually pass them down conveyor belts that are the same size as the molecules we want and combine them in new ways.
What are those little conveyor belts?
They're nanotubes. They're made all the time by nature, like campfires, whatnot, but in small quantities, and now we make them specifically for their properties, and they're very small. They're about the size of a nanometer or less, and they're made entirely out of carbon atoms, like graphene rolled up into a tube. It's like a straw.
100 years down the line, when this technology is everywhere, what does that future look like?
What I'm picturing is something like the size of a mini fridge that essentially can take waste materials and turn them into useful products like fuels and building materials. Or it can pull CO2 out of the air and turn it into fuels or building materials. And so when we're hanging out in the Mars base, this box is going to make everything we need out of the materials that we have with us.
So you actually have a working prototype of what we're talking about, right?
Yeah, so one of the things we're trying to show is pulling ethanol fuel out of water. Right now, a tremendous amount of natural gas energy goes into doing that, and we can reduce that by over 80%. This is a beer, right? This is a very dilute concentration of ethanol in water. And that's what you get from fermenting like corn or sugarcane or wood chips or something like that.
And it's called a beer?
It's called a beer. It's called a fermenter's malt. But it's essentially the same concentration that you would drink, like a double bock or a bottle of wine or something. But in this case, it's clear because we just put ethanol and water together. We actually circulate this beer past our carbon nanotube membrane. This is where the technology is.
That's the carbon nanotubes?
Yeah, they're on the surface of these polymer fibers here.
How small are they?
They're like a...
hey.
They're like 100 times smaller than light.
Than light?
Yeah.
Like than a photon?
Than a photon.
Wow.
So we use the vacuum to pull the ethanol as a vapor through this tube, and it goes to a cold trap. And there's the ethanol as a solid.
Wow.
And then later we'll warm it up and we collect it, and we got some here from yesterday to show you. And this is mainly ethanol. It's over 80% ethanol. One way you know it's fuel is it lights on fire. You want to see?
I would love to see it be lit on fire.
Yes,
all right.
Absolutely.
Let's do it here. Well, this is what you put in your gasoline tank. It burns pretty hot, so stand back.
Ooh.
Wow.
Oh.
Nanotechnology.
I feel like I could toast marshmallows. Perfect.
Domain.com has everything you need for your .com and .net domain needs, and they also have really awesome intuitive website building tools to help you take your professional vision and make it a reality. So if you have an awesome project in mind and want to have an equally awesome website, you should move on over to domain.com. Did you like that?
Oh, I love that.
Cool.
Yeah. The people at domain.com love ConTECHtual so much that they're giving you and all of these cows a discount. You can pick up your domain names, web hosting, email services, and use the coupon code ConTECHtual at checkout for 20% off.
That's 20% off.
20.
20 whole percents. UK-based company Surrey Nanosystems has gotten us closer to true black than ever before. They've actually created a black coating called VantaBlack. It's a cool name. That absorbs more than 99% of all light, leaving a void-like blackness that is eerie to look at.
One square centimeter of this coating can contain 1 billion carbon nanotubes. Here's how it works. When light hits the forest of carbon nanotubes, it bounces around inside those tubes, essentially getting trapped. until it dissipates into heat. That means there's almost no light being reflected back.
The creators of VantaBlack sparked a scandal after it sold an exclusive license to artist Anish Kapoor and his Kapoor Studios for its use in art, meaning no one else on Earth is allowed to use the original VantaBlack for artistic purposes. And that fact pissed off a lot of artists and designers who were looking forward to using it. So much so that artist Stuart Semple decided to make his own super black paint. Now we have Black 2.0.
Hi, Stuart.
How's it going?
What is Black 2.0?
Black 2 really hatched out of a collaboration with a load of artists, and it's sort of an open source paint that we made so that artists could have a really matte black.
This is like a normal black acrylic, like standard black acrylic, and that is Black 2.
Why is having a crazy black so important for artists?
In art, black is a bit of a holy grail. Artists have been after that 0 point, no light black for a very, very long time. And only recently, really, an ultra matte black that absorbs a lot of light has been possible. So it enables a whole new type of artwork to be made.
And you don't use carbon nanotubes, right? What's the science behind this?
We took the cosmetics industry, mattifying makeups to absorb light, new acrylic polymers, and the best, most stable pigments. We put them together to make a super loaded, ultra pigmented paint that reflects 1% less light than the black photographic standard, which is the sort of benchmark, if you like, for visual optical blacks.
So Andrew, it seems like there's a light at the end of these tiny, tiny, tiny tunnels, eh?
You sure are right about that, Dain. You sure are right about that.
Onward!
It's already dinner time?
Do you think the Black 3.0 is just gonna be a hole in time and space?
Probably, that would make sense. Next time, we're gonna figure out exactly what blockchain technology can do.
Stay tuned for new episodes and be sure to subscribe and click the little bell for notifications.